Welcome to the Pyramyd Insider. I'm Tyler Patner. Today we pose the question, do you like it raw? For those of you that don't know or are unfamiliar, rapid air weapons really has its origins out of Theobin in the UK. Martin Rutherford, who was one of the managing partners at Theobin, came over to the States in the late 2000s and started rapid air weapons in Tennessee. Now, up to 2018, these were custom guns. Basically, you had to call up Martin, get one on order, and you could have it built out to your specs exactly. So, long lead times, but very much a custom-built product. In 2018, at the SHOT Show, Air Force Air Guns announced that they were buying Rapid Air Weapons, which is a really cool, very unique merger for them, obviously, already putting out a pretty high-end product, but going into that ultra-high-end realm with an already American-made product and giving them mass scale production ability. Now, for those of you that might be a little nervous about picking one of these up as a production gun, not to fear, Martin is still very much involved in the day-to-day functioning of building these rifles. So he is still there and still a presence, making sure everything is up to those standards that it originally was prior to 2018. So talking features, starting at the front of the gun, we do have kind of an offset or what I like to call eccentric shroud setup here, and it is carbon fiber tubed. So you will notice that the barrel sits up at the top and you have all of your volume of the shroud down at the bottom. Now that gives you the ability to have a lot of volume for that shroud to take up some of that noise without sitting up too high to maybe impact a low set scope. So something to keep in mind, they're definitely thinking about what the shooter is going to want here when they're building these guns. I like this feature a lot. We're obviously going to see how quiet it keeps the gun. Now, the important thing to know here is that all of the rapid air weapons guns that you're going to see on pyramidair.com have polygonally rifled barrels. Now, these are made by Lothar Walther, just utilizing a different method of rifling than a traditionally rifled barrel. Normally, you're going to see that maybe the barrels are a little bit less pellet picky. They do a little bit better in the wind, and you pick up just a little bit of velocity typically from them. But they are certainly kind of the hot ticket item, especially in the long range world right now for air guns. Now, of course, the iteration we have here in this HM1000X is a 25 caliber. It's also available right now in 22 caliber, also with that poly barrel, so keep that in mind there. These are going to tend to like the heavier pellets is what I'm being told by the guys at Air Force. Now, of course, we're going to test it for you guys and see just what it likes and what it doesn't. Dropping down below the barrel here, you do have a 480cc carbon fiber air cylinder, so you're going to get a lot of air capacity, and it fills to 230 bar, so about 3,300 PSI or so, should deliver about 50 shots is what they're telling me, and it is fully regulated as well. Now moving back from the bottle, we do have kind of our V-block setup with our pressure gauge, which reads in bar. Doesn't have a 230 bar marking, which I would have liked, just helps you kind of know where to fill if you don't have an output gauge on your fill setup, but certainly easy to read and a lot of spacing in between those 50 bar markings. And then on the other side of that, we have a quick disconnect fill port, which is covered by this nice little plastic cap here, which is secured by an O-ring. Like this a lot, the fact that they have a quick disconnect ready to go on the gun means no adapters, no fill probes to lose or anything like that. Love that. And moving back, you do have a very large breech block that is topped with a Picatinny rail. I like Picatinny rails, guys. If you watch a lot of our videos, you probably have noticed that. I have some UTG Pro rings, which are actually made right here in the States. I like these rings a lot. They're a little bit pricey compared to some of the other offerings we have on pyramidair.com, but well worth it if you're looking for a solid set of rings. And then topped with that Athlon Argos 8-34, gonna need that extra magnification to really get that fine detail in what I'm doing downrange, because this gun's gonna need it, and this is definitely one where you're gonna want a bit better scope to go with this rifle. And dropping down, we have a very smooth and easy to use side lever system, locks back super nice, not that difficult in terms of a cocking effort there. And in that breech area, you are going to load a 12 round magazine in 22 and 25 caliber that we have here. Now for those of you at home, you'll notice that this looks an awful lot like a Benjamin Marauder magazine. And my understanding of that situation is actually the patent on this magazine that Theobin originally had ran out right around the time the Benjamin Marauder came out, which is why Crossman, and then a bunch of other companies started using this style magazine, which in all honesty is a good thing for the industry because it's a very tried and true magazine design and works very well. The one cool thing that Air Force and Rapid Air Weapons is going to be doing with these guns is offering them in a right hand and a left hand action configuration. So you'll be able to get that with the cocking handle on the right or the left hand side, which I think is something that's pretty unique. You know, you might find for a right-handed shooter that if you're at the bench all the time, you might actually prefer to have that over here. Makes it a little easier to actuate, so something to keep in mind. Now, coming to the other side of the breech, you will notice it does say made in the USA right there, so that is a big thing that should definitely be touted here. This gun, maybe outside of the barrel and the air cylinder, is made right here in the USA, which is absolutely fantastic. Love to see it. And really, Rapid Air Weapons deserved an American-made home like Air Force air guns if they were looking, shopping for somebody to buy them out. Air Force is definitely the right place for them. Now, dropping down to the trigger, this is a match-grade target trigger. It is absolutely fantastic. Out of the box, I have zero, and I mean zero, complaints with this trigger. It is two-stage, fully adjustable as well, and you do have that safety lever that can be engaged right in front of it. You can put it on whenever you like. Again, trigger's very light out of the box. I'm gonna say this is probably in the 6 ounce range, so something to keep in mind for those of you that maybe aren't used to a target trigger. You may wanna tweak it up a little higher, but out of the box, these are fantastic triggers, and you don't need to do anything to them if you don't want to. One other thing I want to mention before we talk about this cool stock here is the hammer spring adjustment at the back of the action. Now, this is actually slotted in the stock, so you can get to it with an Allen key without taking the action out of the stock. But this will allow you to adjust that hammer spring tension and make some fine tuning adjustments to your velocity. But it may have an impact on your shot count if you, depending on how far you go one way or the other. So something to keep in mind there, but gives you that little bit of flexibility to set the gun up just how you want it for the pellet that you select. But talking about the stock we have here today, this is kind of that mountain camo look. It's the green, orange, and gray layup in this laminate. Looks great, guys. This is really eye-catching, but it's going to be available in a bunch of different color layups. So whatever you like, that's what you can get, which is really great that they're offering all those options. On the stock itself, you do have texturing on both sides of the forearm as well as on the grip itself. And you got some nice finger groove kind of texturing for the grip. And then swooping on back, a nice vertical grip angle itself, an adjustable cheek piece, which does have some ability to cant to it, as well as that height adjustment. You have a vertically adjustable butt pad, which really locks in nice and tight. But probably the most unique feature of this LRT stock is the M-lock rail in the bottom. Now, this is really cool. Not only does it also form your trigger guard here at the back, but this gives you the ability to purchase those little M-lock rail slots that you can get at any local sporting goods store that sells rifles, right? Everybody uses them on their AR-15s nowadays, and you can really customize the heck out of this thing. So you can get a short little 3-slot guy that goes in just one of these, or you can get a nice 7 or 13 slot M-lock rail section to put your bipods on, lasers, flashlights. I mean, really, guys, whatever the heck you want can go on the bottom of this. All you have to do is pick up one of those little M-lock attachments and you're good to go. So I like that a lot. It keeps the forestock nice and flat for those of you guys that are going to want to buy these to bench shoot with as well and prefer to use bags or a rest. All right, guys, overall, gun feels great. These guns are well known for being tanks, last a long, long time, and Rapid Air Weapons and Theobin PCPs before them have a very well-known history, not just here in the United States, but the rest of the world as well. I am very eager to get this out on the range and shoot it, so that's where we're headed. Pretty astonishing results out of the Rapid Air Weapons HM1000X here in the 25 caliber. Starting with the Barracudas, which this is our worst grouping of the day at 45 yards. 0.6 inches, this is still a fantastic grouping. 31 grain pellet, so pretty darn good there out of a relatively heavy pellet. Moving up to the King Heavy Mark IIs, a 0.54 inch group. Again, 12 shots, absolutely fantastic, right about a half inch. bettering themselves just a little bit better with the original King Heavies, a 0.51 inch group. Again, 12 shots, and the regular Kings at 25.4 grains, 0.53 inches. Guys, this is basically everything, right about a half inch. Very impressive results for 12 shot groups at 45 yards. I'm not gonna call any of these the best though. I think we have to stretch things out a little bit further and see what they can do. So with the ease at which this gun put half inch 12 shot groups down at 45 yards, I just knew we had to get this thing's legs stretched out a little bit further. So we've measured off 93 yards here in our warehouse. All five shot groups shot from the magazine with the HM1000X, all four of the same pellets. Let's see how we did. 1.3 inch group out of the King Heavy, the standard ones. Not too bad, but I think we could do a little bit better. Kept going, the Barracuda's 1.1 inches. Certainly surprised that the Barracuda shot well out of this, knowing that that Lothar Walther barrel typically is gonna like JSB pellets. The standard Kings, 1.1 inches also. Got a decent little cluster there for five shots, but the Mac Daddy, the best pellets in this HM1000X, 3/4 inch with the King Heavy Mark IIs. That's super impressive, guys. 93 yards, 3/4 inch. Raw says you're gonna be able to do an inch with this in the right conditions at 100 yards. Proof. With the JSB King Heavy, the Mark IIs that shot the best for us out at 93 yards, we're seeing about an 880 foot per second average or so, which calculates out to about 58 foot pounds. So pretty darn close to that 60 foot pound rating and that 900 foot per second mark they say the gun should be getting with those pellets. So not too bad there. Obviously the regulator's doing its job of 15 foot per second extreme spread over 56 shots from 230 bar down to about 145 is pretty darn good in my opinion. And that 3.8 feet per second standard deviation certainly tells us that the reg's doing its job. And something to keep in mind, you do have that hammer spring tension adjustment in the back of the gun. So if you did want to play with the velocity, you can certainly do that. Just know that it's going to impact your shot count. So if you back it off, you're probably going to get more shots. If you increase that hammer spring tension, you're probably going to see a few less. Our esteemed first president, who is riding a dinosaur on my shirt right now, would like to remind you to buy American. And he would also like to remind you to subscribe, like this video, and comment down below. The Rapid Air Weapons HM1000X 25 caliber, this is everything a gun made in America should be. Absolutely fantastic, obviously represents a very high-end price point, but meets those expectations with ease. The one difference between, I've said it before, I will say it again, you know, a lot of guns speak for themselves from an accuracy and a performance perspective. This gun was easy to do that with. Not all of the guns that speak well for themselves with groups are easy to do that with. And this is just like pellet on pellet accurate without doing much effort on the user's end. I'm super impressed with this gun. I think Rapid Air Weapons and Air Force air guns in turn have done pretty much everything right with this gun. My only gripe is that it's a little bit on the loud side, but outside of that, it ain't bad at all, especially when you're considering 60 foot-pounds of output energy. That's a ton for a 25 caliber PCP these days. You know, the bottle fed keeps things relatively lightweight. The gun's got some heft to it, but it's nice and well-balanced. The trigger is absolutely phenomenal, up there with the best of them 100%. smooth side lever, good quality magazine, a beautiful stock that you can fit to yourself pretty easily. I love the Picatinny rail, that poly barrel certainly doing its thing. I'm eager to get more of these poly barrels on guns because I think they're gonna make a huge difference for a lot of reasons. Maybe we'll address that in a separate video. But guys, the HM1000X from Rapid Air Weapons definitely deserves a look if you are in the market for an ultra high-end PCP. This thing is fantastic and you need to check it out on pyramidair.com right now. For the insider, I'm Tyler Patner. We'll see you guys soon.